up. We're marshaling our troops. We're marshaling our efforts. We've got a sign-up page here. You come on over and write us in if you like.
In the coming year, now more than ever, we, the American people, the people of this great country, we must keep the lasagna flying.
Well, it's part of our platform. I forgot to mention that part of our platform, which when he speaks of lasagna, he's speaking in general terms of all macaroni products in general, including spaghetti 8 and spaghetti number 9.
We're more than happy to explain our platform.
And my running mate here is working on a speech right now, which will be ready in a few minutes. I'm sorry?
One is a space alien and still threatens this planet.
Now be sure when you turn on your computers, folks, let it warm up. You don't want to send any emails too quickly because you risk tearing the web. We're that confident, folks, that we're going to win, that we're already writing our acceptance speech.
And we're thrilled that you're here to let us bounce it off you. We're going to carry you all on our shoulders. We're not going to forget about a single one of you.
Anything that can be contributed, whether it be a vote, whether it be talking with the members of the community, or a large donation, will be appreciated and used. But especially if it falls in the latter category. Because we're not looking for soft money in this election. In fact, we're not even having an election. We're just having an erection.
Now that my colleague has talked about soft money, I'd like to assure you all that we're not going to abuse the privileges of your soft money that you donate to us for our campaign. We'll make sure it's well spent. Not a penny will be wasted or earned. No, your donation is essential for the smooth operation of our campaign. As you may or may not know, soft money and hard money have now been outlawed. The only kind of money left is the plastic kind. We'll take credit cards, though. We're also putting together a new gallery of velvet drawings, velvet glow-in-the-dark drawings for the Lincoln bedroom.
What language does it mean, dark whatever?
Oh, that's an old proverb from Aramaic. Thanks. Aramaic, as you know, we're reviving that as one of our...
Listen, you should get a sizable vote because nobody is responsible.
Hello. Here? How is the soft money contribution been coming along?
No.
Well, we decided to cut corners. Instead of spending money on individual 6-packs and 12-packs, we're going for the keg.
We like to sit more than stand for a few simple new ideas in politics, don't you think?
Well, for
newscasters on the nightly news, after they report a horrible tragedy, should be required to cry.
Right. Mandatory.
And this also includes mandatory smoking in the White House, in the Lincoln bedroom.
Until it's outlawed, we, your representatives, will poison ourselves with cigarettes until the madness ends.
We promise that we will not get up earlier than noon until we're elected. We're going to make these sacrifices in the name of the American people. We're going to watch only 3 hours of TV a day.
You know, when laws are outlawed, only outlaws will have laws.
Well, very well said. Very well said. Anyone recognize who said that? Anyone remember? Think back in your history books, folks.
Jesse James.
That's close. Billy the Kid. Oh. It was Billy the Kid before he disappeared into the mountains.
Well, speech right here. So you'll be the first to hear it, folks. It seems like it's ready.
Fellow Americans,
this is the meat of the conversation.
If elected, I promise you change. The kind of change you want, the kind of change you need. That's right, quarters, nickels, dimes, yes, Pocahontas dollars. Read my lips, no paper money.
Soft money will only be spent on objects that are soft, and hard money only on hard objects, for example, plates, knives, and forks. Basketballs are somewhere in between because they're soft before you inflate them, and then they're hard when you inflate them. So we're going to have to spend some of our soft money and hard money on not just basketballs, but all inflatable sporting goods and blow-up dolls, even including those, you know, those Bozo the Clown punching bags.
Just maybe a minor thought to add, but minor maybe not so minor. Our crowd has thinned momentarily, but maybe everyone here now can carry.
We're not eating well enough.
Could be. Anorexia is very fashionable. I neither support nor oppose that. But I do believe that if marriage is outlawed, only outlaws will have in-laws.
Yeah.
The internet bubble has burst. You know, .com this, .net that. What else is there? I mean, what's behind it all? Besides, of course, Satan.
What we want, and I do believe I can speak for all of us in the world, is a new, indeed, a new America, an America for Americans, for Native Americans.
We're sick and tired of all those young, beautiful people walking around having a good time.
Well, we're sick and tired.
We're sick and tired of people sitting around in their living rooms peacefully smoking grass.
Well, we don't.
Well, we don't. We worked hard to rip off the American people. I mean, to support the American people, and we intend to keep going.
You know what?
And what?
Tired.
And we're tired of it.
Damn right.
We're tired of it, folks.
We got my vote.
Wait, listen, the back of the dollar bill states in God we trust. Now, this is a religious nation. But I admit it, folks. We mustn't let the satanic counterculture of good times and rock and roll screw things up for all the rest of us hardworking Americans.
Well,
it's not so easy to come up with a presidential platform.
A pleasure!
How's this for a presidential platform, huh?
Huh? Where's yours? I'm sick and tired of this. It hurts. Hi, my name is President Dave. Did you vote for me?
Read my... I'm Mary Jane. I used to make brownies and things like that, you know. And have ice cubes in the refrigerator to get high on.
And now what do you use?
Now I have not on a restricted diet. I only could have potatoes and pierogi and all kinds of restrictions.
Seafood.
And I seafood all the time. It's getting worse. My eating habit is very bad.
You have to say you feel more prosperous today than you were 4 years ago? Or
today, yes, I feel more prosperous today. I used to make $50 a week when I first started working, and then I worked for 33 years and got laid off, and now I'm more prosperous on welfare.
Really?
Yeah. And I eat better than I ever did, going everywhere and getting free food. That's what I, and using my money to pay the rent. Yeah, I'm really prosperous in this day and age. After working 33 years, I have nothing to show for it.
Anyway, I'm sick and tired. I'm sick and in sleep tired.
Just got the town meeting section of the debate left, and this is the part of the debate where we take questions from the audience and illuminate and clarify our posture and stance on the these important national issues.
Water.
Yeah.
Drink water. Would you buy water with hard money or with soft money, or would that differ depending on the temperature?
That's a good question.
That is a very good question, and we've spent a lot of time. We spent a lot of time passing it back and forth because It's an ever-changing question, as you know. Sometimes water is in a solid state, sometimes it's in a liquid state, and sometimes it's a gas. I mean, that's the nature of this remarkable substance, water, is that it changes states.
We really did take it from...
I mean, it's something we discovered on the campaign trail, and we're happy to share these scientific breakthroughs with everybody.
Mercury, for example, is also, well, it's a solid, it's also a liquid, it's hard to say. It can also be a gas, but I don't trust it because it's very slippery, it's very slick. Mercury is slick, it's slippery, like, you see what I'm saying?
The underdog, you get an Uber dog, and that's what we are, folks. We consider ourselves the Uber dogs. There's one of them right now, mascot finally showing up. One of the Uber dogs, bowling. It's a national anthem for the working American. That's what we're really working for, folks, because face it, how many people can sing four octaves? Can sing that scale from bombs bursting in air to all through the night?
And now as we initiate our new anthem, rather than stand, everyone feel free to slouch.
If slouching is the posture.
That's the direction you're going in, slouching.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream.
And then someone else starts.
Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Row, row, row your boat. Row, row your boat.
Our party. We like to put the word party back into party. But yeah, let's put the right kind of party in politics.
We're keeping the right, yeah. That's right. Hallelujah!
Yeah. We're against the usual crap, you know. But we're also for some things which our competition doesn't want to talk about. Like, we're not afraid to be part of certain conspiracies. No, not at all.
Okay. We're going to have an underground tunnel going from the White House to the moon. It's going to be completely underground, so no one will ever know that we're going up to the moon. We won't have to have fancy rocket ships that cost the American tax people. Oh, Metro cards will be accepted, I just found out. Will that be the collectible Metro card? We're going to have stopping off points underneath in that tunnel, because it's a long way for people who get tired along the journey. We're going to have, you know, those Chinese, those massage guys where you sit down and you put your face in the ring? And that's all there is to it. And we're going to create jobs that way. We're going to create jobs by filling up the Sea of Tranquility using hydrogen and oxygen, which exists abundantly on our moon's surface, creating water, creating a new atmosphere, creating jobs, creating a resort. It's going to be a Club Med type resort. These days are treacherous days for the American people, folks. We face econo-cataclysm. And what else?
Homicide.
Bambicide. The apocalypse of the human imagination. The commodification of childbirth. The banishment of frivolous good for the sake of the almighty dollar.
I'll put my knapsack on my back, my rifle on my shoulder. I'm going away to Shiloh. And there I'll be a soldier.